Hello, little Amy. Nearly 4 years have passed since I uploaded 3.006 in September 2017, so I'm delighted to announce free open source Seamless3d 3.007 is officially ready for download. So why did it take so long? Without getting into all the details, a major task was getting Seamless script to compile into 64-bit machine code, and another was getting Seamless to render with OpenGL, which frees it to render many more polygons and makes Seamless much closer to being cross-platform. I've rewritten most of the nurbs auto-stitching code to make Seamless handle a wider range of scenarios when experimenting with different structures in organic models. This rewrite delayed 3.007's completion by more than a year. And there's this new feature that lets you add Seamless branches very quickly to create a tree. Perhaps the most noticeable new feature, which wasn't very challenging to add, is this item bar for importing into a model or a scene. This, with some preset items, makes Seamless one of the easiest modelers for a beginner to build something. All you have to do is click on this item bar, preset for 1 meter blocks, select the item and click in the 3D window to add it. I've kept all of the items to simple geometrical shapes so that the art you create will feel like it's your work, but it's easy to create your own custom items like I have here and add them to an item bar. And you can create and add your own item bars too. In search of textures at Dingo Point. When I got back home, I could see an insect was on this prized texture found at the top of Dingo Point, but I was still able to sample a big square of it by using the paint.net rectangle selection tool at an angle. I used the free online seamless texture generator from imgonline.com.ua, which evened out the texture nicely. Using a simple algorithm I wrote in C++, I generated many of the sandstone textures from this single texture by altering the colours of the pixels in accordance to how dark each pixel is to maintain that lovely sandstone sparkly effect. In the summer and autumn of this year, I was unable to venture far from the house due to all the grass pollen caused by all the rain we had. So in this time, I could only find small stones for my textures, but this goes to show you can still get good textures without finding big rocks. I still really like how my cobblestone work looks from this tiny little green sandstone. All of the textures for the items are derived from photos I've taken of objects found on the farm, except for a few of the wood textures that I drew. All of the items and their textures are free for commercial or non-commercial use. In the next video, I'll show how anyone can easily build this cute little house using preset and modified blocks that come with 3.007. I close this video with some footage of me picking some bush lemons for our Saturday's fish and chips.